Ah, today's the day. We all know what it is. It's Halloween. And I'm just waiting on Carl and Sheen to get here, like always.
Bing dong! Knocks us on your doorbell!
They're here!
Just kidding, it's me!
Hey, Carol!
Sorry. Sorry, I tripped on a pebble walking inside my bed.
And Sheen?
Hey, Jimmy!
Late as always.
Archelord!
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Jimmy, what's going on, dude? It's Halloween!
It's Halloween!
It's Halloween!
No. No, I don't think it is.
No. That will not catch on.
It is not Halloween.
Okay.
It's Halloween!
It's Halloween!
It's Halloween!
Oh, spooky! Ooh. Where are the ghosts?
When the green screen skeletons walking across the screen.
Boo! Did I scare you?
Ooh! Ooh, that ghost moving around is so scary. Ooh, it almost touched me. Ooh. Ooh. Wow. What are you dressed up as, Jimmy?
Oh, you know, the same old Albert Einstein.
Ooh! Ooh. Such a classic. You know, I never guess what I am.
I don't know, are you,
Are you your favorite animal?
Are you a werewolf?
Yes, are you a werewolf that looks pretty werewolfy?
Looking a little furry.
What? No.
Talking about the costume texture, Carl.
No, I'm an albino llama.
You guys never guess who I am.
You sure?
Come on, guess. You never guess.
Ultralord?
Ultralord?
Is it Ultralord?
Yeah, it's Ultralord.
How'd you guys know?
I don't know.
Let's just get on with the video.
I had a hunch.
Yeah, let's just get on with the video. We've been wearing the same costumes ever since we started.
Yeah, who gives a shit anymore? But anyways, you guys ready to go do some trick or treating?
Yeah, let's go do some trick or treating!
But before we go do some trick or treating, I got something special.
Something special?
Boom.
Whoa!
McDonald's was doing that thing. You know what this is called?
What?
It's called the McPumpkin.
The McPumpkin?
The McPumpkin.
What would McDonald think of next?
I don't know. I do not know.
Does our trick-or-treat pail?
Yeah, this is what we'll be hauling all of our candy in, boys.
Wow. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Wow, just, that was quick.
He just left.
All right, well.
Come on, Jimmy.
Let's walk off like normal people. Okay, we go trick-or-treating.
Oh, hey, Jimbo.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, Mr. Neutron.
Oh, so you guys about to go out and trick-or-treat?
Yeah.
Yeah, but we're so excited.
If you get out of the way.
Oh, well, you better be back home soon, Jimbo.
Why's that?
Yeah, why's that, Mr. Neutron?
Oh, well, you see, Jimbo, it's that time of the year.
It's that time of the year? I don't know what that time of the year is.
Well, it's a long story, Jimbo. Let me explain. So, about a few years ago, Jimbo, there was the oldest man living in Retroville, and his time had sadly come. And the Grim Reaper came for his soul and tried to take him down to the underworld, but he was ready for him, Jimbo. He was ready for him. So he put a curse on him, and that curse ends tonight. 100 years later, and that curse ends tonight.
100 years?
100-year curse?
That doesn't sound very feasible.
Yeah, it doesn't sound very, very realistic.
Yeah.
Well, let
you mean
me tell
you. Like a 10-year curse or something?
Well, I mean, no, 100 years, Jimbo. This happened a long time ago.
Okay, doesn't really sound possible, but still.
And today's the day, Jimbo. So, be weary. There could be some spooky spirits, Jimbo.
Alright, I guess we'll keep a lookout.
Yeah, we'll be careful, Mr. Neutron.
We'll keep our eyes out.
We'll keep our eyes peeled and open like a banana.
Yeah.
Alright, Jimbo. Said. Have a good night.
Alright, you too, Dad.
Yeah, you too, Mr. Neutron.
You guys ready to get some candy?
Ooh, I'm ready to get some candy.
Ooh,
I'm
ready to get some candy and get all spooky.
Carl, open that door. Let's go get some candy.
Let's go get some candy.
Let's go get some candy.
Want some candy?
Let's go get candy.
These young miners?
I don't know, sir. I think they're trick-or-treaters.
Trick-or-treaters, you say? Well, give them a raise.
Are you sure, sir?
Did I stutter, Smithers?
Okay, you'll get your raise at the end of next month, kids. Happy Halloween.
Wait a minute. These two don't live in Retroville. Where the hell are we?
Oh boy, what a night!
Yeah, no, we got so much candy!
Yeah, and a Ninja Turtles VHS, and $130 from Weird Al. Thanks for holding the pail for us, Jimmy.
Oh, no. Oh, no problem, guys, no problem. But anyways, I think it's getting kind of late. We should probably get going home now.
What the?
What is that?
What the hell was that?
Who's talking? Thunder! What was that, Jimmy?
I don't know. Look, I know what I just said. I know I said we should go home.
Yeah, but pretty wise.
But I think we need to do some investigating.
What? Investigate? Jimmy, are you being serious?
Yeah.
We're not the Mystery Incorporated.
Look, I know we're not Scooby and the gang, but like, I'm dead ass serious. Dead ass. I think we should go investigate.
Okay, Jimmy.
I know we're spooked. Let's go check that out.
Okay, I think it came from that direction.
Okay, then let's go.
Alright. I think it was over here somewhere. I don't know where it is, but I swear to God it's over here.
You sure?
Yeah.
What the
hell is that?
What the?
Jeez! Oh, that hurts every time. Boo!
Where are you? I'm gonna move this.
I'm the Halloween spirit, young boys.
The Halloween spirit? Wait, Jimmy.
What?
You don't think that this is the guy from your dad's story?
He's real.
I think this is the guy. He's real.
Oh my God. Are you the guy from the Retroville legend?
What legend? What do you mean?
Well, our friend's dad here told us that a few years back, the Grim Reaper came for this old guy, and then he put a spell on him and the curse.
Yeah.
And then, you know, tonight he can break the curse, or
yeah.
You know, then yeah, the curse is broken tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, well, okay. Yes. That is me. I am the Grim Reaper. Well, former Grim Reaper. Anyways, my son's now in position since, you know, I'm cursed and all.
Wait a minute. So, like, you're the Grim Reaper?
Yes.
But in the legend it says the Grim Reaper came for an old guy.
Yes, he got the jump on me. He cursed me.
Oh, okay. I thought you were cursing the old man.
No. I came for his soul because he was dying. So, but then he cursed me and.
Oh, okay. I must have misheard.
And every day is endless suffering.
Why?
Why? Look at me. I'm attached to a goddamn trick-or-treat ball. It's horrible. And also, your dad was wrong about the curse? What do you mean?
Yeah, what was he wrong about? Yeah, it seems pretty accurate.
He said tonight the curse is broken. Wrong! The curse is not broken. I personally
have to break the curse myself.
Oh.
And tonight's the night. And if I don't get the curse broken, I'll be stuck like this forever.
That sounds horrible.
Yeah. Also, so, like, how are you going to get rid of the curse?
Yeah, how do you break the curse?
Yeah, how do you break the curse? Ultra Lord thought I said it. Well, since you asked, the only way for my curse to be broken is for someone to take a piece of candy from the bowl. And oh. Then I'll be free.
So, it's that simple?
That simple, huh?
Yes.
So all we have to do is not take a piece of candy?
What do you mean? Break the curse, take the candy.
What? Why would we take the candy?
Yeah, why would we do that? It's dumb.
We really think there's a catch here.
Yeah, plus, like, we got plenty of candy already. Plus a VHS and tons of money.
Yeah, so, $130, right. In fact.
So why would we take some candy?
Yeah, why? Because to break the curse, you know, help me. I've been stuck like this for 10,000 years.
Whoa, 10,000?
Jesus Christ, damn. Your dad was way off when he said a few years back.
Yeah, he said 100 years.
Yeah, I know. Curses get a little iffy when they're not broken properly.
Damn, it must be like the Middle Ages or something.
I had someone take half a piece once, and it didn't break the curse. And
what?
So it extended the curse, actually, and it sucked.
That doesn't sound right. That's dumb.
They grabbed it, and before removing their hand, ripped it apart.
Oh.
Yeah, and you know what sucks about the curse?
What?
Is that, you know, I have a motion sensor activated inside of me, and when it's triggered, I go off and involuntarily my eyes glow and I say a phrase.
Oh.
It's awful!
Yeah, that sounds like hell.
Jimmy.
And, like, you're supposed to be distributing hell.
Ooh.
Oh, what you doing,
the
Carl?
The payday bar, Jimmy.
Carl, no.
The payday bar.
Yes, take the payday bar, take it.
The payday bar, Jimmy.
Carl, don't take that payday bar.
It's my favorite. Carl. But the payday bar is my favorite.
Carl, you don't need the payday bar.
You don't need it.
Look, why
but
do you
it's
think
free.
You because it's free?
Yes, Carl. And it's my favorite candy.
Carl, look, if I could just go to the store and buy you payday bars.
But it's not free.
Carl, if I buy you a payday bar, then it's free.
Yeah, because you didn't pay for it.
Whoa. Okay, come on, guys. Let's go home.
Yeah. Let's just go home and leave the Reaper to his, I don't know, reapings, his karma?
I guess.
For doing his job?
Wait. If you break the curse, I'll give you something special.
Like what?
Enticing.
Well, if you break the curse, you'll get... I don't know. I just really want you to break the curse.
Hang on a second. Hang on, guys. So, we can break the curse, but...
Oh, wait, I know. You can't leave unless you break the curse. You can't leave.
Well, that's kind of dumb. We can
sounds
just leave.
Pretty bogus.
Yeah, it's not like you have some kind of shield or protection that's gonna, like, kill us or something if we leave or
curse us.
Not
like there's
us.
Any clause or anything that, you know, says we can't leave.
Yeah.
No! You brought up the exit clause.
Wait, is this actually an exit clause?
What the heck?
By law of the curse, you have options. You can either free me from the curse by taking some candy, by the way, to the payday bar, your favorite, or you can take the ghosts of voodoo past and, you know, this year's new flavor.
You stupid, you done fucked up.
I don't think you know who you're talking to.
You're talking to some pretty good Mountain Dew enthusiasts right here.
You're talking to some Mountain Dew fanatics.
You're talking to some political Mountain Dew connoisseurs.
Mountain Dew enthusiasts.
So does that mean you're not going to take the candy and free me?
That's a big no.
Yeah, it's gotta be a big no.
We're gonna take the Mountain Dew.
We're gonna take the Mountain Dew.
Hate to, Dating Dash, but,
No. Please.
We're gonna take that Mountain Dew.
Please don't go. Please.
Mountain Dew, boys, here we come.
Please don't go. Please, no. No! No!